Thank you.
Thank you.
I shared a big bed with all of my giggling sisters. Days they were filled with many a task. Daddy worked real hard, but the best times of his life were when he played his fiddle and many were dance. Well, we always had supper on the table. Daddy did his best so we could eat. Though we had no palace, our home it was warm, and Ma did her best to keep the house neat. One year we had a harsh, bitter winter. Dad got a fever and sadly he passed. Ma was never the same, 'cause the best times of her life were when Dad played his fiddle and Mammy would dance. Now I'm all grown up and I've just one sister. Ma left us quite soon after Daddy passed. And I still haven't much, but I'm rich with the memory of when Dad played his fiddle and Mammy would dance. Of when Dad played his fiddle and Mammy would dance. days in toil and tonight spinning dreams outside her window. One cold winter night, no water had they. Harsh mistress rang her bell and sent the young girl in the frosty night. 'Twas the last time she saw poor Pagonia. Well, the icy stones slip 'neath her cold feet, crying the night, and she of Pagonia. the skies are surely clear again. Such magic in a girl. Madeline, bonnie, bonnie Madeline. Angels are watching closely from heaven. Madeline, bonnie, bonnie love is gone. My love is gone. My love is gone away. In another's arms, I thought greater joy. My
This is a time to celebrate the Musicians Workshop and all of the graduates that have come to pass to date. But tonight, a very special upcoming graduate named Skylar. So this is a celebration of her 4.5 years of going from, you know, no experience to magnificent. And where it goes from there, well, you will hear where it probably will go from there. Come on up.
Oh, this song that I'm going to be singing is called Carrick Fergus.
I was in Carrick Fergus.
I'd like to take this opportunity to thank John and Jane Laskin, because without them, I would have never gotten here. I went from a little 11-year-old who didn't even remember her name, who went on stage, and now they've given me every opportunity in the world. So thank you very much, John and Jane Laskin.
Thank you. Thank you, Skylar. I said, magnificent. I am a huge supporter of Musicians Workshop because of results like this. It is incredible what John and Jane have done, and I'm a huge supporter and believer in what they do. They make miracles and young lives.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Well, yes, this is a very unusual contraption on my lap here. A lot of people look at it and they see wire coming off of it, and a box of electronics next to me, and they say, what do you call that? Is that like electric bagpipes, or is that a pump in there, or is that your air supply? And actually, it's not. These are the traditional Irish bagpipes, and the proper name for these is the Illan pipes, and in Irish Gaelic, Illan means elbow. So the reason it gets that name, as you can see, I'm not blowing into this pipe. I've got a bellows under my right arm here, which pumps the air, sucks the air in through this little intake, and I pump it, and then there's a tube going across my stomach here, and it goes into the bag. Now, from here on out, under the left arm, it becomes what people would identify as a bagpipe. It's traditional, like I said, to Ireland, and it's not very old in terms of bagpipes. Bagpipes go back to the times before Christ. In fact, if you want a little bit of unrealistic Hollywood nonsense here, I was just involved, and we just finished doing the music on Friday. What day is it today? On Wednesday, for a new film called Troy, that you might have seen trailers for. But anyway, the composer, James Horner, who's hired me several times for Braveheart and Titanic, was doing the music for Troy, and he said to me, he called me and he said, the bagpipes are old, aren't they? I go, yeah, they go back before Christ. He goes, well before Christ? I said, yeah. He goes, you want another gig? They go way back before Christ. So anyway, you'll hear these pipes on the movie Troy. But in saying that, bagpipes are very old, but the Irish pipes come about from, they're a hybrid of the Scottish pipes, which are much older. These go back to about the late 1600s, so they're not very old as far as bagpipes are concerned. But the interesting thing is they have, like I said, the bellows and a bag. The chanter is the melody instrument. Now, I'm going to turn off my electronics here, because this has nothing to do with the sound of it. It's only to amplify it, otherwise you wouldn't hear it. This is how loud they sound normally. So that's the chanter. Now you've got drones, which play a drone. And then you've got these other keyed pipes on my lap, which are called regulators. And what they do is they play chords along while I'm playing a melody. So if you can envision this, here's a little bit. So anyway, here's what's going on. I'm pumping with my right arm. I'm squeezing with my left. I'm fingering on the chanter for the melody. And then the Irish were smart enough to say, well, wait a second. We're not doing anything with this little part of your hand right here. We can use that somewhere. So they have you tapping these little keys here, which are like basically closed chanters. The regulators. There's a bass, baritone, and tenor. And you can either hit two at a time and play a little chord, or you can sort of somehow do contortionism and get your bone on one of these at one time to just play one note. But anyway, I'll say one more thing. The Irish are actually very, very smart people, even though a lot of times they're the butt of jokes in Britain. It's usually the jokes of the Scotsman, Englishman, Irishman. Well, here's where the Irishmen outdo the rest of them. You see, since you don't have to blow into this pipe, they were very, very smart, because they invented a bagpipe where you could drink while you play.
Goodbye.
distance and spaces between us. You have come to show you go on. Near, far, wherever you are, I believe that the heart does go on.
Near, far,
Ladies and gentlemen, Scarlet Rivera, Eric Rigler, Pamela Mattioli, Tom Adams. Unbelievable.